Hey everyone, Walker here. Today we are talking jigs. Why use jigs? Well, if you're gonna do a ton of objects like these pins, it's a lot better to set up a jig to do all of them at once rather than engrave one at a time. A total pain in the butt. And today we're going to show you how to build a jig for chopsticks. First, we'll want to measure our object. This is a chopstick. We're going to make a jig for our chopstick, and it's roughly 10.5 inches. For smaller measurements, I like to use the calipers. Make sure that they're on. They work the best that way. And then we're going to design our design, and it's going to create the jig, and we're going to have our digital setup created appropriately for our objects. Make sure to space them out properly and get your jig ready for RE3, whether you design in our software exclusively or something like Illustrator or Inkscape that you can bring right in to work with RE3, no problem. And we're just going to go ahead, find a piece of material, and cut our jig. Ideally, this would be out of acrylic, because acrylic won't bow on you like wood, but we're just going to do this fast and quick for a good example. Remember that you'll want to cut out the outside of the design so you have it nice and square. And there you have it, we have our jig. And now we're going to place our jig in the upper left hand corner and sort of square it up to everything. We're going to move the laser until it's in the upper left-hand corner on that very edge. I like to turn off the light and then get a little bit better visual on that red dot diode and just dial that in. Then we're going to put our chopsticks in, or whatever it may be, coasters, anything of that sort that is pre-existing that wasn't exclusively made with the laser that you want to engrave. In this engraving, we are going to unplug the air compressor because we don't want the air blowing around our light, delicate chopsticks. We're going to run our perimeter and it looks good. We're going to close our lid and get the job started. Remember that this is in relative mode, so starting in the upper left hand corner is just how that functions. Then we'll just engrave one chopstick after the other, and that way we don't have to babysit the machine or do these painfully one at a time. And now our chopsticks are ready. Ready for use at Mr. Snow's Chinese Cuisine. And there you have it. That's how you engrave pre-existing objects with no problem in a mass production setting. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments section. We'll get to them, share the video, and until next time, keep making.